Okay, so what we're gonna do now is the Kong precision. So the idea of connecting a Kong vault to a precision. So of course, your precision should be on lock as well as your vault. So what's gonna happen now is you're gonna have to initiate a lot more power and not only just go for technique, but you're trying to get a little bit of height and distance as well. So the trick to this one is don't slow down. You're actually gonna run at this at a moderate pace until you get comfortable, then you're gonna be able to run as fast as you want and as fast as you can. So as you're sprinting the obstacle, it's gonna keep your chest forward on this one. That way, all your momentum's channeling in that direction. It's gonna come up into the hurdle, like we've shown before. You're gonna Kong through, and it's gonna take, you're gonna have to use a lot of your tricep, okay? Tricep power to really launch yourself up. Bring your knees to your chest as much as you can, and then again, start to load for the precision, okay? So, one more time, it's gonna happen in a Kong. My hands, so pay attention to the hands again. What you're gonna wanna do is you're gonna wanna push through your hands in a follow through. So as your hands push, you're really trying to pull your arm back. That's gonna allow your chest to come up, because the number one mistake with a Kong vault is people stay too far forward. You wanna run with your chest forward, and then after the Kong, use your arms to get your chest up and start bringing your knees up so that you can load for the landing. Otherwise, you're gonna go head first right into the second wall. Yeah.